right. I just faced said event at the bank and still didn't get resolved because I sat there for about 30 minutes and I got tired of sitting there. And they just come up and ask me useless questions, and other people sitting there with the, you know, they have four desks for, you know, representatives or whatever, but there's always only one or two people in them. And, you know, the lady there, you know, I hear her talking and not even talking about what they're supposed to, you know, it's like the fucking customer's like, oh, is that your child? Oh, I have one. Oh, let's talk about our children now for 15 minutes. Oh, let's get back to the banking. Yeah, there's people waiting. I don't care. Wheel of Fortune's not on until 7:30, so that's good for me. Now, you sure I'm not going to get charged that extra $1.50? Because I did use it at a TD Bank place, so I shouldn't have that $1.50 charge. I mean, my husband Walter is going to be really upset when he sees that. Oh, you know, I would like, would you like me to knit your child a little blanket? Because that's what I do, I knit and things, and then I come and I sit down in the bank, and I take up the chair for a fucking hour and talk about nothing but banking. And I need everything fucking done for me. Fuck, man. So now I'm not that fucking care anymore. You know, that fucking bank don't seem to fucking care about it. This fucking jerk off right here. Fucking asshole. Fucking people, man. They you know, no concept of anything that's around them. They have most people have no concept of what is in front of them, what is behind them, what's next to them, what's above them, what's below them, what's in front of their fucking nose. Nothing, man. All they know is like, ooh, me. Oh, there's a parking spot there. See, I'm in Times fucking Square. Let me double park and block the whole fucking flow of traffic for a half an hour because I want that parking spot that's right there. Fuck. Frustrate me like you wouldn't believe, and I don't want that, you know. I try to get along with people, I really do, but they just make it so fucking impossible. I need to go to the fucking gym, like, just fuck everything in the world right now. I'm going to the gym and I'm getting my fucking head right. Oh, yes, I have my headphones here. That's good. I thought I didn't have them for a second. God, but that fucking bothers me. It's like, are you that fucking clueless that you don't realize there are people sitting in the chair waiting to do some banking and stuff, too? That you gotta really sit there and then, you know, call fucking Alfred on the phone to get a special password and all that bullshit. Fuck, man. Like, what are you thinking? Other people have schedules and have to do shit too. You know? Don't fucking talk about your kids in there. Let the lady do their fucking thing on a computer and get the fuck out of there so other people can go. Fuck, man. And I notice a lot of people do, I call it like nervous talk. They're nervous talk. They don't know what to do. They're confronted with a stranger. Whether it's a stranger, you know, a fucking Sears associate or a fucking banker or whatever. You know, they just turn to, oh, or the waiter. You know, oh, no, don't touch that. The waiter didn't come back yet. Oh, don't say nothing to the waiter. Fuck you. You know? Say nothing. If people don't care about their time, doesn't mean I'm the same way. Got enough shit going against me. Always did. And I can't allow time to be fucking ripped from me like that. Fuck, man. Fuck, it gets me mad. The whole time I wasted going up there and everything, man. But, you know, it's like I see it everywhere, unfortunately, you know? I also see some change. I do notice a change in a lot of people for the better these days. You know, this new life that we have now and this coming and the Aquarian age. But there's still a lot of fucking assholes, man. A lot of fucking dense fucking people. Dense fucking selfish, egotistical. Self-important fucking asshole. Problem, I think, is most people who are clueless, because, like, you can say, I heard even Jordan Peterson say on one of his lectures, he was saying, like, you could tell by people's faces kind of, you know, what they're about a little bit as you're walking by or on a busy street. You know, and he said, like, the people have either two kind of looks, like, either one kind of look where it's like, you know, like, whoosh, overwhelmed, and whoo, and life is just blowing them fucking over, and they're just a victim of circumstance, and it's the way they carry themselves, and the way they shuffle around, and everything. You know, and then there's a smaller fragment of people who are focused. They're leaning into time, you know, they're leaning into the day, to the hour, you know, they're focused, they're on point, you know, they know what's in front of them, what's behind them, what's around them, what's above them, what's below them. They know all this, you know, and they can, and they consider it in their actions. So it could be when they do something, it could be for the best of all, not just for the best of them, you know. Like the woman fucking in there taking up all that fucking time talking about anything but banking. Or any fucking thing to do with being in a bank. But I was a good boy. I didn't say anything like I have in the past. To fucking, you know, rude fucking people who waste my time inadvertently. I let them know it usually, you know, and I, you know, yeah, you might could see this and go, oh, he's fucking negative or something, you know, fuck you, I'm anything but negative. And what I'm doing now is I'm venting, right? Like what you would do to a therapist, but better, because you don't have to pay for it, and, you know, you can talk about what you want and stop when you want. And I don't know what to do with this feeling of anger that fucking builds up in me from things, you know. Well, I do know, and I'm taking care of it right now. Alright, the worst thing that's happened in the past week or so to me has not been getting fucking sick again and getting better on my own. It's been, I haven't been to the gym in fucking, I can't remember when. Sometime a week or two ago. It's been horrible. You know, even my girlfriend notices it. You know, she's like, did you go to the gym today? You know, because she notices the difference in my tension or whatever later at night when you talk. And I notice it, man. I'm doing my video. I was doing my med. See, I can't even fucking talk because I'm so bottled up from a week or so without going to the gym, being sick, laying around, fucking just feeling like nothing but space, you know, horrible feeling. Getting better all the while. This whole week it's been fucking, you know, freezing fucking cold for March. And when it's not freezing fucking cold, it's gray and rainy. So it's wondrous for my personality. You know, and it's just, there's no denying it. Every time I do it, you know, every time I stop going to the gym for any reason, real, legitimate or illegitimate reasons, fucking bad shit happen. You know, it's just not good. I mean, I was before I got sick again last week, and I was going good again, everything. I was on top of my temper and everything. You know, I was on top of a lot of shit. And then all fucking goes away. I got sick. A couple days, fucking hard. And I noticed I get so out of whack, you know, like yesterday, I was pretty good, mostly all of the day, still resting, recovering and shit. Then I went to go see my girlfriend last night, and she lives in New York, the city. And I was driving there, right from, you know, Kearney. And I hit the GPS and I took the fastest route, it said to her. But for some reason, it was not the fastest fucking route. It was the worst fucking route. And not only that, there was some kind of accident or something. So I was stuck in traffic for about 25 minutes or so before I even got out of New Jersey. I was furious in the car. Like, I was fucking cursing. You know, I didn't punch anything or anything like that. But I just, no matter how hard, it's like, all right, don't blow. Because I see the red fucking line coming up, you know, and that means stop, everything stops. And I just sat there and I could not contain myself from cursing and getting furious every couple minutes. And I knew it was wrong. I knew it was wrong because I knew I had gotten better with that. And now why am I slipping back and fucking losing my mind over something that I have been in control over recently, like traffic and shit. And I just, you know, and then it was just like one fucking thing after another, man, you know, potholes, fucking, and I just kept getting angrier, you know, the whole ride there, but an hour, it took me an hour, which is ridiculous, and the whole ride there, I was just furious, like, you know, and I couldn't control it, and I knew I was out of control, and I couldn't, you know, it took me a while to bring it in, even when I got to her house. I mean, it helped a lot getting there, seeing her, but it took me like a good 5-10 minutes after I got in the house to fucking like just unfold, you know, relax. I always liken those moods to that I feel like a piece of paper crumbled up that can't uncrumble. And I'm sitting here looking at all the cars in the parking lot at the gym, and that's making me mad. The car in front of me is making me mad. Fucking green light's making me mad. Oh God, I just gotta get into the fucking gym. It's all I gotta do is get into the gym. That's all that matters. That's all that matters is get into the gym, get on the treadmill, and do fucking... I've been doing 20 to 30 minutes walking at 4 miles an hour on the treadmill before I start my workout with the weights and shit. Now today, I'm a bit full of fury again, and I want to fucking do 30 minutes and go crazy with the weights, but I also know I can't do that either, because every time I do that, well, I always fucking get myself sick again, or it takes me forever to fucking get better. Alright, what the fuck is this shit now? Alright, I gotta park my fucking tank of a truck. I think it's so big, my truck. And I haven't even added anything to it, you know? Like no kind of lift kit or nothing. Oh, it feels good to be back in the parking lot here. I don't know. I don't like people fucking looking at me either sometimes. You know, it really bothers me. I don't like anyone fucking to look at me sometimes. And in this area, or New York City, or anything like that, that's all they do, is they fucking stare too much and too long. And I don't like that. All right, I'm going into the gym. And then I come out, I'm going to tape my attitude to myself driving back to the house and see what kind of a better mood I'm in. And then when I get to the house, I'll mix up this whole tape because I gotta, this is a bunch of clips, everything from getting blood work yesterday and that ordeal and everything. And there you have it, there you go, here I go. Tuesday, I'm going to say Monday, March 16th, today is the 25th year anniversary, my black belt, March 16th, 1996. Finish eating. Couldn't sleep last night. I like shit all day. Off and on. I'm debating. I'm just gonna take a shower. Maybe I ate too much. I mean, I don't want to go lay down again. Fucking sick of it. It's only one day. It's enough. And I need the warm weather. Just took three Advils. I'm not good at this. I'm being sick, a rundown, fucking whatever it is. I could barely like stand up and make breakfast today. I was supposed to go get blood work done, and I didn't go. Or tomorrow. Can't remember the last time I've been to the gym. Okay, it's fucking crooked. Who cares? All right, I had an idea. I said I'm going to record me back to life again a couple days later, and I'm feeling better now. And I'm putting my shoes on to go out, do a few errands, I go to the gym, first day in a couple hundred years, I'm back. And I kind of want to put it next to the day I was started getting sick. Anyway, little funny thing that just fucking happened. These little things never cease to amaze me. I'm putting the phone in the tripod thing now to catch this, do this stupid little bit. And I get into a little fucking war with the remote control thing that they have on a very not so well thought out clip on the base. It looks like, oh, it's easy. You just, okay, oh, it holds it there so you don't lose it. And then you just can get it, and it looks like that. So I'm holding the phone up with one hand, put it in, I go to get this thing out, and the fucking thing is in there, like, kung fu grip, like,
I'm moving the whole tripod, just trying to get this fucking thing out. And then it becomes a war. All right, am I gonna have to take my hand off the camera and hold this so I can pull it out with two hands? Or can I just pull it out with one hand like it looks like you're supposed to do? You know, and it's just like, I don't know what it is. And then I get into these little wars with things. I'm like, fucking no, I'm gonna win, you know? But am I really? If I'm wasting time, or is that a matter of my ego or something, you know? Just fucking do the other hand and use it. Does it have to be, fucking win right all the time? But I don't know, it's just how I am. So, anyway, this is a kind of, victory, a little time here for me. Because I've recovered again from, I don't know, probably what it's like, the fourth time I've had COVID or something. And the end of the winter. I watch it closely every year. And this is the last week we will see 30 degree temperatures around here. I know it. And it's, you know, it's going into tomorrow too, you know? It's fucking hilarious. There may even be the chance of snow tomorrow morning. Unfucking believable. Unfucking believable the way the winter hangs on. But it's dead, it's going, it's the last week, and that's it. And then it's all 50s and 60s until the thing runs out on the screen. And then after that week, next 7-8 days, I can't, there's no way it can go fucking colder. Back down to the Arctic fucking 30s. That we have here in the middle of fucking August. Alright, so that's it. And also, this is a little, take the egg, crack it, open. I have to do that too with making the videos, because if I stop doing something for one day, whether it's martial arts, anything, it's like I don't know how to do it again. And I have to go through all the procedures again of, like always new or something, you know, but kind of cool because I always had that feeling. All right, and one of the best things of all I can impart to you, my YouTubian brethren, is being able to identify in yourself when you're bullshitting yourself, when you're scamming yourself, when you're self-sabotaging yourself out of weakness, fear, laziness, complacency, mediocrity, anything. Any lower vibration energy you're giving into. You can't do that to yourself. You're fucking yourself. You've got to be hard on yourself twice as much. And you know when you're bullshitting yourself. You know when you're trying to fucking waste a little time here, so maybe you'll be a little late getting there. You won't have to really deal with that thing that you don't want to. No, you gotta stop that shit, halt it in its tracks, fucking kill it every single time it rises up in you. And it could be anything from something as little as going to the bank, answering the door, making a phone call.
I'm in a blood work place. Something about... I don't like to do anything these days that involves me having to take any kind of order at all from anyone or anything. I'm furious at my doctor for having wanted me to do this, but I know I have to do it once in a while. Check the levels. Lithium.
You know the new high tech and
I just can't get over how cold it is outside. For fucking March. I'm so sick of these masks.
I went to a broom game and I caught her out there and she came inside and told me please not to say nothing.
Is there a Jason?
Yes. We'll be right back. Oh man. Now you see. I should be halfway done on the treadmill right now. Right? But I'm a fuck because I didn't bring my headphones to the right one. So I had to go back to the house and then go back to the gym again. Fuck my treadmill.
I didn't realize how hard the guy could hit and how fast he was.
I was totally confident. The closer I get to the ring, the more confident I get. The closer, more confident I get. All day in my training, I've been
thinking,
I thought this man might be capable of beating me. I've dreamed of him beating me. But I always stayed afraid of him. But the closer I get to the ring, I'm more confident. Once I'm in the ring, I'm a god. No one could beat me.
Of course, I get the light, right? Look. Yeah, I'm just trying to go to the gym, you know, see if I can figure that out. You know, make sure that's not too fucking hard. But you see, evil force, you will never beat me because I will never stop. I will never stop. Said I get my kicks out of enduring, remaining. For some reason, I have to keep this on because I'm to the point of anger and frustration, everything, until I get to the fucking gym. Because this kind of keeps me calm a little bit. Like I don't, you know, want to look like too much of a fucking nut. But it is, I think it's good to document these fucking bad states, you know. I don't think it's good that people just try to put up all, like, great things all the time and all fucking great stuff and all fucking sunny days and fucking smiles and fucking, you know, puppies and rainbows and shit. It's not even count. I gotta get the whole dentist thing going too. Fuck! Get in these moods, man. I feel like I could just fucking pick cars up and throw them. I know, you know, it's fucking cool out. Well, you know, fucking walk in my shoes. Oh, they're probably like, oh, the fucking weirdo's back again 10 minutes later into a parking spot. What's he gonna do now? Now I'm gonna fucking work out. Huh. Nope, I didn't work out that quick. Oh, see, I'm leaving. I didn't even get out of my truck. You know why? Because I said, oh, good thing. I got fucking headphones here. But they're the wrong fucking ones. They're the ones that go into my iPod. They don't go into the fucking iPhone. So it doesn't have that fucking adapter. So I had two choices. Go work out with no music. Which means I have to listen to the gym's music. And that's not even music. It's that... that music that fucking makes me nuts. You know, that... fucking, you know, that nice music, you know, that, you know, hey, I'm a nice guy, you're a nice girl, isn't that groovy, you know, fuck you. Like, one time I recorded some of it. It was like, in the locker room, it was like, down, down. Like, it was like the most ridiculous fucking music to work out to. Like, yet all these people are. And I'm like, oh, okay. Not me. I cannot do it. It distracts me. I mean, I can, but I don't want to. You know, our music is a huge part of working out. It really amps me up. Luckily, I don't live that far from home. I mean, the gym's not that far from the house, so. See? But again, it's little things like this that can test me, can test anyone, you know? Oh, so look, now I'm driving back to the house. I didn't get to complete what I wanted to at the bank, but wasn't my fault. So I'll call. Later, after I go to the gym. Now, you know, so this could make me, but it's not, but like, oh, I could go home, go in, get my iPod that goes with this. Luckily, I started charging it before I left, so I know it's ready. And then I could go home, I could get sidetracked, you know, you can get a fucking bullshit phone call from somebody, and get sidetracked and then fucking miss the gym or something. But that is not happening. So that is not happening. Godzilla cannot stop me from getting to the fucking gym today. You know, I know the evil force that's working against me is pulling out all the stops because it knows I fucking went through another winter. I made it through another fucking winter. And the spring, summer, fall is mine. I thrive. And every year, it's like every last week, oh, well, unseasonably cold temperatures this time of year. It's normally supposed to be, 48 degrees. And, you know, currently this week, it's, it's minus 20 below. And we're going to get 15 feet of snow this morning. And turn to afternoon rain. Shower fucking mix. Look, everywhere I go, I'm seeing cops, you know, fucking today. What are they following me or something? All right, cops, I'm going in to get my iPod. Is that all right? Am I allowed to do that? Or is that breaking a fucking law? Wouldn't be surprised.
No, he says things. That's why
I'm so furious.
Just let them know.
I'm not about study about
it.
I subsided.
My daughter,
as I get things done. And I can get back on my own.
I have to educate myself a little bit more.
All right. Blood work is done. I took 2 bottles of blood. Feel pretty good though, now that that's over with. Now I want to go tackle more things on my to-do list. Or do I follow my instructions I laid out for myself last night, which was every time I get sick, it always never goes away because as soon as I start feeling better, I go immediately right back to full swing, whatever I wanted to do or whatever I was doing. And now this time I made a note. I said, even when I get better, I'm still going to go rest like I was still sick for a little while before I throw myself back into life. I had to go to the dentist, just teeth made, a lot of things. Just let my truck warm up because, like I said, it's still Arctic winter out. You see my parka I had to wear? It was so fucking cold before. Trying to make me stay sick. I still have my clock an hour slow. I didn't change it. Alright, I think the beast is ready. And I'm going to shove off. Such a disgusting, 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 wet, rainy fucking day.